In this video, I will be asking a series of questions about the lower respiratory tract, but most of my questions will end up being about the lungs. If you're curious as to what terms this video will cover, just look in the description and I will have included a word bank. So first question is, what is this tube? What is the spot where that tube divides? And when it divides, what do we call these? So this is the trachea. The spot where it divides is the carina. And going to each lung is a primary bronchus. How many lobes does the left lung have? How many lobes does the right lung have? And what are they called? The right lung has 3 lobes, the left lung has 2. The left lung is smaller because you have your heart on your left side. This would be the superior lobe, middle lobe, and inferior lobe, whereas the right just has the superior and inferior lobe. What are the dividers between the lobes? This is the horizontal fissure, and these are oblique fissures. Remember, oblique means diagonal. This space here and the space on the inside are the cardiac notch. So we said that this was a primary bronchus. Coming off of that are the secondary bronchi, and off of those would be the tertiary bronchi. How many secondary bronchi does the right lung have versus the left lung? So the right lung has 3 secondary bronchi. They are also called lobar bronchi because you have 1 for each lobe. The other name for the tertiary bronchi is the segmental bronchi because each tertiary bronchi goes to a different bronchopulmonary segment. What are bronchopulmonary segments? Bronchopulmonary segments are areas of your lungs that are divided by connective tissue, so they're separated from each other, which is convenient because if part of your lung needs to be taken out, they can just take out the affected bronchopulmonary segment without interfering with the other ones. So entering the lung, there's a bundle which includes the primary bronchus and the pulmonary arteries and veins. What do we call the bundle? The bundle is the root. Now, if I were to rip out the root, there would be a little notch left over. The notch is the hilum. What's this blood vessel? What's that blood vessel? So these are the pulmonary arteries. These are the pulmonary veins. Remember, artery just means it's going away from the heart. So these arteries are going away from the heart to pick up oxygen. And then once they pick up oxygen, the veins are returning to the heart. So we know primary leads to secondary, secondary leads to tertiary. What are the next 3 levels after tertiary? So tertiary bronchioles divide into bronchioles. Bronchioles divide into terminal bronchioles. Why are they called terminal bronchioles? What are they the end of? The terminal bronchioles are the end of the conducting zone. That is the zone
which is only transporting air. It is not allowing for gas exchange. So because that is the end of the conducting zone, that explains the name of the next bronchiole. They are respiratory bronchioles because they are the start of the respiratory zone. The reason they are the start of the respiratory zone is because they have something hanging off them alveoli. So after the respiratory bronchioles, what comes next? Respiratory bronchioles lead into alveolar ducts, and alveolar ducts will lead us into alveolar sacs. So what is the difference between an alveolar sac and an alveoli? It's very simple. An alveolar sac is just many alveoli. So we can say an alveolar sac is a cluster of grapes, and an alveoli is like a single grape. And if you're interested about what the alveolar ducts, sacs, and alveoli look like, I have a histology video on that that you can find if you look for my respiratory playlist. All right, I hope that was helpful. Have a great day and have fun learning.